A very good morning to all my dear students of class 7. Today I will teach you Hop, Skip and Jump, which is the first chapter from your English literature unit 2 syllabus. Okay, so Hop, Skip and Jump, this chapter is about a street game which is played all over India, not only in India, in different parts of the world also. A lot of variations of this game is played. This is a very popular game among the children. A street game is played on the streets rather than in an area specially prepared for it. It is usually a simple playtime activity that children do in their neighborhood. So children generally play this game in their neighborhood, in their pastime. It is a game which can be played both indoors and outdoors. And children enjoy playing it with their neighbors, friends and all. And in different parts of the of this country, the game is termed in different manners. Not only in India, in European countries, different parts of the world also, a lot of variations of this game is played. And this is a very popular game among the children. The one street game every little child in India has played is Tapu, Ekkar Dukkar or Kitkit. Kitkit is played all over India. It is known as Kunte Bille in Karnataka, Pandi in Tamil Nadu, Tokkudu Billa in Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and Khane in Kashmir. The game is called hopscotch in English. It is a part of our childhood. It is a part of our childhood. So, the different names in the different parts of our country is mentioned here. So, this para is very important for MCQs, that in which part of our country, how this game is termed. It is a good game for children because it needs very little space and can be played both outdoors and indoors. A chalk is used to draw a grid of 8 squares on the ground with numbers from 1 to 8 as in this picture. With numbers from 1 to 8 from this picture. The grid is drawn with a chalk on the floor like this. To play the game, a player needs a marker such as a flat stone, a small piece of tile or shell. The player stands behind starting line and tosses the marker into the first square. Then she hops on one foot from the first to the second one and continues hopping till the eighth square. At the eighth square, she turns around and hops through the square till the second square, and here she pauses and picks up the marker from the first square, hops over the first square and steps out. Then she tosses the marker into the second square. The game continues like this until all 8 squares have been played and the player completes the round successfully. All hopping is done on one foot unless there are two lateral squares where the player has to land on both feet with one foot in each square. Now students, you all know, this is the description of the game. You all know better than me how to play this game because I have played it long back and maybe you are playing it still now. So, there we need a marker. What is a marker? A counter used for playing the game. Okay. A marker is a flat stone or a piece of tile or a shell. So it is tossed. At first it has to be start from the first grid. So it is thrown here. It cannot touch the outside lines. So the player will hop or skip, we'll just skip this one and hop in one feet. Okay, So jump from here to here and go here, place both the feet, again here, again here, again she will turn, she or he will turn, and again return both feet, one feet, one feet, will pick the marker and just jump over here, and next the next one, like that the player will have to do. Okay, this is how this is played. So all the hopping is done on one foot unless there are two lateral squares where the player has to land on both feet, with one foot in each square. Hopscotch is simple, but it is a game of skill. It requires physical agility. Agility means all of you know what is agility. Ability to move with ease and quickness. Thus, agility is the flexibility of the body, okay? And nimbleness means swiftness. So both the things are required. Agility, that means flexibility of the body, and nimbleness, that is swiftness. And tests the player's balance and precision. Balance and precision. Precision means perfection. A player is considered out if the marker does not land in the right square. While tossing the marker, it should be placed on the particular grid where it is required. After completing one grid, it has to be put on the next one and it has to fall on the right place. Okay, so we have to keep in our mind that it should fall, it should be tossed on the right place. Okay. A player is considered out if the marker does not land in the right square. Then the other player's turn comes, okay? Square touches the borders of the grid or it touches the borders of the grid. The player has to be careful, okay? Or if the player loses balance and touches the borders accidentally while jumping, skipping, the feet of the player should not touch the borders, okay? There are several other rules and variations of the game which add to the fun and difficulty. There are other variations also which add to the difficulty. Okay, so this is how this game is played. Next, it's a very short chapter. In the next part, we will get to know about how it is played in the different parts of the world. Okay, and what is it termed in different parts of the world? So you just read up to this. Next part I will teach you tomorrow and discuss the question answers. It's very easy. Okay, so today up to this, I will tell you to read the chapter again and again. And one more thing, those who have played this game or are playing this game, very good. Those who are not yet playing this game, I would request them to play it. They can play it for improving the flexibility of their body. It will help you to have to grow patience in you, to concentrate. Okay, so you can go on the roof of your house and play this game, because this is very, very, very important for each and every child at this lockdown period to be physically strong. The amount of energy that you used to lose while playing at school should always, every day, you all of you should play these games at home. So your physical abilities, your strength is never compromised. Okay, so play this at home also. So bye for today. See you tomorrow.